Everybody really understands Iowa State, Iowa. They get it. It's a big deal.
Sure is. It doesn't matter if you're a Cyclone or a Hawkeye. The interstate rivalry is a big deal for football fans in Iowa. It's a rivalry that dates back to 1894.
But it wasn't really until 1977 that the game became an annual matchup. News Channel 8's Angie Hunt in the Ames Live Link with the history of this interstate rivalry, intrastate.
Well, Kevin, it was actually a game back in 1934, where Iowa State upset Iowa 31-6. That put an end to the rivalry for 42 years. Now, from that point, it took lots of negotiating. The Iowa legislature even got involved to bring the big game back. It's a battle for bragging rights.
ISU! ISU!
That has a long history in the state of Iowa.
Coaches, players, fans, it's a big deal. It is a big deal.
And it was a big deal when Tom Randall and his teammates walked into Kinnick Stadium for the first time in 1977 after a 42-year hiatus.
Environment was just electric. I mean, it always is, but even more beyond, I think, because everybody was just going crazy.
Crazy is one way you could describe the history between Iowa and Iowa State. Over the years, there have been allegations of questionable calls and plays. Players who would exceed their eligibility to play for Iowa and then Iowa State, or vice versa. At times, this friendly rivalry hasn't always been so friendly.
There was feeling in the 40s and 50s, well, the two teams should not play because it just brings on so much bad will between everybody, and everybody gets too excited about it.
Some things never change, and if there is one thing Cyclone and Hawkeye fans could agree on, it would be the excitement surrounding this big game.
When that series resumed in 1977, there was no doubt that this was a huge athletic event that the whole state would fully embrace.
A lot of hard hitting. The Iowa guys know what it means. I mean, you teach the out-of-state guys what it's all about.
Now, Iowa State lost that game to Iowa back in 1977, but the Cyclone team went on to the Peach Bowl that year, and the team will be honored at this weekend's game. Many former players and even Coach Earl Bruce plan to be back for all the festivities.
30 years, a long time. Angie, I guess kind of an honor to mark the anniversary. The Cyclones are going to be wearing throwback uniforms, right?
That's right. They're going to be wearing uniforms that are similar to the ones the team wore in 1977, but there's one exception. The front of the jerseys won't read, "Beat Iowa," as they did back then, 30 years ago.
Indeed. All right. Thank you very much, Angie. Probably a good idea.